Good evening.
Thank you for the
good evening. Yeah, so you are all welcome to today's Angigo lecture series. Yesterday we did something on literature exploration and want to continue from there. After getting your literature, what do you do with it? You want to read the literature, you want to capture people's ideas and then develop your thesis out of it. Is that not it? After capturing people's ideas, the ideas are not yours, so you should tell us where you got the ideas from. That is where citation comes in. Do you understand it?
Yeah.
If you don't do the proper citation in the academia or in the scientific environment, they will say you have plagiarized, which is an offense. Okay? So to avoid plagiarism, let's do the citation, the in-text citation, and then the reference list. And referencing can also be a tedious job if you do not have the skill and the techniques and the tools to do them. So it becomes handy when someone has access to reference managers, and there are several reference managers or reference management tools. Okay, one of them is EndNote. We've been introduced to EndNote already, and I know we can all use EndNote. One of them is Zotero, RefWork, RefMan. We have the Mendeley. Today, we want to focus on Mendeley, how to use the Mendeley to organize our reference list. Okay? All right, so let's start with Mendeley. We are starting from the scratch. We do not know what Mendeley is. We do not have it on our machines. So we're going to download Mendeley and then see how we can benefit from Mendeley. Okay, so we launch our browser and then let's go to Mendeley.com. You type Mendeley.com in the address bar. Mendeley.com, it takes you to the home page of Mendeley. Okay, so we are there, almost there. Good. Once you are on the home page, and because we do not have account, you'll be asked to create account. It's essential to create the account because Mendeley comes with in two forms. We have the desktop or desktop library, what they call the Mendeley desktop, and then the online version. What it means is you can work from your laptop, the desktop of your laptop, or your terminal. Again, when you are online, you can do the same thing. The online becomes handy when you are not with your machine, assuming you've traveled somewhere and you still want to do your work. You just go online and then do what you have to do. Once you are through, you just synchronize and it will reflect in your desktop for you. Okay, so let's create an account. So, first name. I have an account already. I want to use somebody's name to do it. Rex.
I have already.
Who is having more than Dela? Have you done yours? Okay, let's use Dela's. Okay, so first name, Dela.
Yes, Dela.
Okay, surname.
A-D-O-U-N-U.
N-U. Email.
Dela Yadu.
Please come around then. But still come around. Your password, you will not mention it.
Oh, I know already.
Enemies in progress are here.
Password, red
star. Okay, so you type your password for us. Good. Okay, so we are creating an account for Dela.
Dela, your phone.
Okay, so academic field of study. We will take arts. Do you have social science?
Yes.
Okay, social science. Where are you? She's a social scientist. Okay, so social sciences, academic status. Dela Lee.
Professor.
Professor Delali. Great. I think we are through. Good. So with your institution, University of Health and Allied Sciences. Then I'll add my whole to it. I should use what? Okay, so we are moving on. We are doing this for the sake of our virtual audience. I know most of us here are having the software on our machines. Good. So now we have an account for Delali. Now after creating the account, the next thing to do is to download Mendeley Desktop. Mendeley Desktop. Okay. So download Mendeley Desktop for free. Start download. Okay, so whilst it's being loaded, let's talk about Mendeley. Mendeley has a lot of functions. One of them is it allows you to organize your library. It comes in the form of library. Okay, when we say library, it's not necessarily the physical books that we see. It could be, you know, electronic materials. Good. Mendeley allows you to keep your PDF document. It gives you a space of 2 gigabytes to keep your PDF materials. So when all your documents are PDF, then you don't need even a pen drive, because Mendeley will help you to keep them. Okay, and now whenever you put your PDF materials in Mendeley, it also picks the bibliography details. When we say biblio, it means book. So bibliographic, it means about books. Okay, so the bibliography details of the material. That's why we have bibliography, the list, the details about the material you used. Okay, so Mendeley will automatically pick the bibliography details for you. Okay, so we agree to the terms. Yes. Next, then we install. Alright, so our network is being a good boy today.
Wow, that's me.
Finish. So now we have our desktop library downloaded. So let's go to our desktop and see if you can see it. Okay, so
the password is sweetheart.
So you make sure that you type the correct login credentials. Try it. Let's try again. Okay, don't worry. It didn't come.
Oh. Have you gone to a mail to accept the have you gone to your mail to confirm your
The mail she will be able to open before you can go and
No. Your mail, your email. Your own email.
You used to have
Gmail. Gmail, eh? Gmail. Okay, let's go into your mail and then see if they have sent a message.
Yes,
Gmail. What's wrong? Okay. We have to go to the process again. Alright, so now we have our Mendeley desktop downloaded. So we want to open it. So Mendeley desktop is opened. And like I told you initially, Mendeley desktop comes with three panes: the left pane, the middle pane, and then the right pane. Okay. It is the left pane that's used to organize the library. And the middle pane is the library itself. Can you see it? Okay. Now, if I click on any document in the middle pane, the details will show here. The bibliographic details will be showing here. You see, all the details are here. So this particular one, strategic planning for marketing library services. The journal is library management. The author is here. The year of publication, blah, blah, blah. I told you that this thing has the online version and then the desktop. You realize that I'm not using my desktop. But I use my email to sign in. I have all my information here. Can you see it? Mm-hmm. So assuming I've traveled somewhere, I can just pick somebody's laptop, just download Mendeley on the desktop, and then I'll get access to my document. Okay. So how do we get our document into Mendeley? Before I come to that, let's talk about how the things are organized here, the organization, my library. So we have my library. Anything I download into Mendeley will appear in all documents. Can you see all documents?
Yes.
Yes. Now, if I put something right now, to appear in all documents and also appear in recently added. And if I read something, Mendeley has the capability of telling me that I've just read an item. You see the green thing, the green icon here. So if after reading a PDF document here, I want to tell Mendeley to remind me that I've read this document, I'll just click on the green thing. So when you see the green, it means that I've read the item. This one is telling me that the PDF is available, so I can download. Okay, so let's try and download this one whilst we are talking.
But mine is not displayed that way. It's displayed in the form of PDF.
PDF. Yes, we have the PDF, but this one is telling me that the PDF is available, so I have to download it. Now I've downloaded it. Let's go back. You will see the PDF. Can you see it? Can you see the PDF now?
Yes.
So these icons are telling you that the PDFs are available. You can download them. Are you following?
Yeah.
Good. The green is telling me that I've read this article. And then the star here, I can click on it. And then I'll star it to tell me it's a favorite article I want to read.
Okay.
Do you understand it?
Yeah.
So this is so powerful. And you can do a whole lot of things. You can read your PDF from it. I can read my PDF from here. If I read the PDF and I find a part very interesting, I can annotate. Can you see it? Like you are doing in your printout document. You can do the same thing here. If I want to put a note here, I can still put a note here. Can you see it? So it's very helpful. You don't need a paper document anymore. You can do everything from here once you have your PDF. Okay, let's go back. Now to the part for organizing the library. We see the favorite. I've talked about the favorite. Can you see this symbol, the question mark? Anytime you download something and there's something wrong with the bibliography details over here, Mendeley will show the question mark to tell you that that article needs a review. So that you work on it. Do you understand it? So that on the day of your citation, you don't fumble. Good. So, having talked about this, Mendeley also gives you the chance to create folders. So that the things will not just be, because it's a library, it's supposed to be organized. So I can create folders. Maybe I'm doing my thesis, chapter one. I can create a folder for chapter one. And then put all articles relating to chapter one in that chapter and that folder. I can create a folder for chapter two in that order. I have a folder A, folder ABC. I have folder ABCD, doctors, Ebola. So I was writing something on Ebola. All those related articles will be here. Loyalty, they will be here. Are you here?
Yeah.
Good. So you can create as many folders as you want. This is how to create a folder. Can you see create folder down here?
Yeah.
I just click on create folder and type whatever I want. What should I type?
Malaria.
Rex. No, rush. Rex trash.
Rex trash.
Rex.
Trash.
Is it T-R or T-H?
T-R-A-S-H.
Good. So, Rex trash.
Yes.
So, anything relating to Rex trash will come here. All the trash will come here.
Yes.
Okay. Now, you can create as many folders as you want. Now, there's another part that I'll talk later. I'll talk about later. Create group. I'll come back to create group later. Okay. Now, let's focus on how to get items into Mendeley. There are about 7 ways to get your items into Mendeley. And I'll talk about all of them. One of them is to use this icon. Can you see add files? Can you see add files?
Yeah.
Good. So you go here and then you go to add files. So wherever that PDF is on your computer, you go and pick it. So let's see if you can get some PDF. So everything in that folder has been downloaded into this library. Please, can you see it? Good. Now, let's go to NIST review. Can you see the question mark here? It tells me that the items I downloaded or I brought NIST some review. We realize that the authors are not there, the title, the year is not there, so I have to do them manually. Do you understand it? Good. So that is one way to go about it, to use the add files icon. Okay. Another way is also, but before we go on, I want us to download 1 or 2 articles onto our desktop so that we will use it as an example. So let's go to PubMed. Let's go to PubMed. and download one or two articles. Good. Malaria in Ghana. What is wrong? PubMed.gov. Good. So, this one, we can download this one. We can download this one. We can download this one. And we can also download this one. Okay. So, a PDF. PDF. This one doesn't have the PDF. Okay, so this one, we can get the PDF. PDF. Okay. Start download. Okay, so one is ready. Open. And the other one too is loading. Good. So let me go and save it. Good. So control article 1 desktop. So it should be on the desktop for us, article 1. Good. Then the last one is downloading. Okay, so this one too is almost through. What is it?
Data corruption.
All right, let's go on. At least we got one article, okay? So back to Mendeley. So one of the ways to do is to use this. So again, we can use the same option to go for the article we just downloaded. Remember article 1. It was on the desktop, so look for desktop. Then article 1. Okay, here is it. So open. So we should find it in our Mendeley Library, Article 1. Can you see it?
Yeah.
This is the article. So in when it comes in Mendeley, it will not use the name that you used to save. But Mendeley will pick the bibliographic details. So you realize that this article is non-falciparum malaria infections in pregnant women in West Africa. The authors have been given. The general name is Malaria General, published in 2016, volume 15, issue 1, page 53. Can you get it? Good. So once you get the article here, the software will pick the bibliographic details. That is one option. Another option is to use what we call the watch folder. Watch folder is simply means that you create a folder and you ask Mendeley to watch over it for you. So what it means is Mendeley will be watching over that particular folder, and anytime you put something in that folder, it will capture it. So we will create a watch folder on the desktop. So we create a folder on the desktop. Okay. Now we will name it. We should name it watch folder. Okay. Watch folder. Okay. Now this is how to tell Mendeley that you've created a watch folder. You go to file. Okay. Now when you click on file, can you see watch folder?
Yes.
Click on watch folder. Now we are coming to look for the folder that we created. We created it on the desktop, isn't it? So let's go and look for desktop. Up there.
Middle.
So double click on desktop. And then look for that particular folder, watch folder. Can you see watch folder? Okay, so come and check it. And then apply. After applying, you okay it. Okay, now what it means is anytime you put any article in that folder on the desktop, Mendeley will pick it. Let's try something. Let's try. I've copied some. I've copied some folder and files we are going to paste in the folder. Okay. So let's see. Good. So we have some files here. Can you see information literacy among undergraduate, blah blah blah?
Yeah.
Good. Let's go back to our Mendeley. Information literacy. Okay. So let's open the article and see how it looks like so that we can trace it. Okay. No, this is not an article. Good, we have one here. This is information literacy among medical students in the College of Brab. So let's go and see if you can see this article in Mendeley. Information literacy. You can actually search. Wow. Information. Literacy. Among. Can you see somewhere?
Yeah.
Among medical students.
Yeah,
is
there.
Medical students. Where is it? Okay, the first one.
Yeah.
So you realize that anything we put in the watch folder is here. All the things we put in the watch folder will be found here. And once it captures it, just click on it. Now you find, you see the bibliography details. So when you are doing your referencing, it just picks them for you. So you don't waste your time. Please, do you understand?
Yes, sir.
Once the article finds itself here, through the watch folder, Mendeley will pick the details that you need.
Question.
Yes.
Can you set more than one watch folder?
Yes, you can search. You can set more than one folder. Yes. But always make sure that you trace it through Mendeley.
Okay.
You understand it? Uh-huh.
Sure.
Yes.
Can you go back
through this process? I should go back through this process again. Okay. No, no problem. Yeah, it looks like magic, but it's very real. Let's download more articles into the watch folder.
Okay. Internet, God, you can.
Yes. So even you can name the watch folder as chapter 1. So that all your chapter 1 will be in the watch folder. And then you make it a watch folder.
So it doesn't actually mean that things should be called watch
folder? No.
Oh, okay.
It does not necessarily mean that you should name it watch folder. You can name it Rex Trash.
Yes, Rex Trash.
As usual. Rex Trash is our...
Default.
Our folder name, the default name for this class. Okay, so let's try and download more articles.
Yeah, I'll call it for which folder?
You can also call it wizard folder. It looks like a wizard.
Hey, it's not pressing.
This one does not have a PDF. I want those with a PDF so that we can actually PDF, because the software we are using is a PDF organizer.
Okay,
so one is here. Okay, so Rex, I'm going over it again, the watch folder. Now, the watch folder works in this way. You create a folder on your computer, any part of your computer. It can be on a desktop, my document, even on your pen drive. Okay? Now, after creating the folder, you go back to Mendeley, and then you go to File. Okay? Now, under File, you will see watch folder. So, you click on watch folder, then you trace the location where you put your watch folder. So we put it on the desktop, isn't it? So we'll double click on the desktop, and then the various folders on the desktop will come. Then we'll go and look for ours. Ours is watch folder. So watch folder, where are you? Can you see watch folder? Good. So when you see it, then you check the box beside it. Okay, so this is checked already. I've unchecked it. Now recheck it. Can you see it?
Yeah.
Good. After that, apply. Then okay it.
Okay.
Now, any article we put in the watch folder is supposed to appear in Mendeley. And it doesn't just appear. It appears with the bibliography details too. Is it okay now?
Mm-hmm.
So that is one way. Now, we've learned two ways. Another way too is the normal click and drag. So I have the article on the desktop or a folder on the desktop. I can just click and drag over here.
The whole folder.
Mm-hmm. Everything you need will be there.
And you can see what is inside the folder.
So let's go back. Everything, it will not come as a folder. It will copy the individual files. Okay. Do you get it?
Yeah.
Okay. Yes, Rex, what's your problem? Yours is not working. So we've checked click and drag. We've talked about watch folder, isn't it? We've also talked about the using the add files icon. Can you see it?
Yes.
Good. Another way to go about it is if you are observant, you realize that most articles, journal articles, come with DOI. Some number is called DOI. Have you seen DOI before?
Yeah.
Let's go back to the articles we downloaded. Okay. Let's see if this article has a DOI. Good, it does. Have you seen DOI? This one.
Yes.
Can you see DOI?
Yes.
Good. So if you have an article, for instance, you have a paper-based article, and you want to get the bibliographic details, okay, the only thing you need to do is copy the DOI. Just copy DOI. So I'll copy the DOI. Now I'll go to Mendeley. When you come to Mendeley, go to File. Okay. Now go to Add Entry Manually. Now in Add Entry Manually, scroll down and you will see DOI. Can you see DOI?
Yes.
You realize that the magnifying glass beside them is not active. Now let's paste the DOI there. Can you see now that one is active compared to the others? Okay, just click on the magnifying glass or the search. Good. So it goes online and then looks for the bibliographic details for you. So after that, you just save. So once we save it, it's on your computer forever and ever. So anytime you want to cite that particular article, you just pick it. Are you here?
Yeah.
Okay. Are you making progress?
Yeah.
Okay. So, should I introduce another one or we should go over this one? Is it okay?
We want more.
Okay. So,
when you have the article, you have to look for the
URI. So, you have the article and you want to import it into your Mendeley desktop, okay? You just look for the DOI, copy it, and then go through the process, paste the DOI, and then search for it. The DOI, you will get it from the article. So most, it isn't every article that has the DOI, but most articles have the DOI. DOI means that Digital Object Identifier.
Okay.
They are unique numbers or codes assigned to articles. Okay?
Yes.
So you copy the DOI.
Is it down there at the beginning?
It will be part of the citation. Okay? Then you come to File, Add Entry Manually. Then you scroll down, you see DOI. You paste the DOI. It is a unique number assigned to the articles. So you realize that when we search it, we went straight for that particular article. So you search. Sorry, it's not here. So you search, and then within the shortest possible time, if you have a fast internet, it brings. So look at the title and look at the title for this one. Is it the same thing?
Yes.
Intramuscular. Is the same thing. The author is the same thing. The journal is the same thing. Everything is the same. So you save. Is it okay? Okay, so now let's move on to another one.
So when you save it, what will it appear?
It will be. So you go to recently. Recently added. I'm coming. You know why we are seeing this? Because I have searched for something I have not deleted. So just go to recently added. It should be here. Can you see it? The first one. Can you see it?
Yeah.
So all the things we've downloaded are here.
Yeah.
Good. Now, another way to also go about it is to use this particular tool. Can you see literature search?
Yes.
Good. So this is like a Google search. I want to find something on malaria. I don't have any material in mind. So, malaria in Ghana. A whole lot of things come. Now, I go through this and maybe I'm interested in this one. A study of malaria care provider choice in Ghana. I click on it. The details are here. Then they ask you, save reference. Can you see? Please, can you see?
Yes.
So I save reference and that's all. It's on my desktop. So let's go to recently added. Can you see it? And then everything will be here. Are you okay? Good. So we've talked about DOI, literature search. Can you see that's what we just did? Watch folder, click and drag. We've also talked about using the add files folder. What again have you talked about? Okay, now DOI, we've talked about DOI. Another thing we can also do is if you have a paper-based document, the details are there, but you can't just insert the paper into your computer, okay? But you are interested in the paper, you've used the paper in your article, so you want to keep the records, the bibliographic records. This is how to go about it. You go to file, you go to add entry manually, and then you fill this. All the information required are on the paper, paper article, okay? So if it is a journal article, you choose the document type. So journal article, if it's a book, you pick a book. So assuming I go to the library, I pick a textbook and I use it for my thesis, okay? I need to do the referencing. So I come here and then go through the manual entry. So it is a book. I select a book. I type the title here. How to use Mendeley. Okay. Authors. Rex. Trash. Year 2016. Pages. Maybe two. Okay. Then for a book, you need to provide the publishers. Some. Edition, second edition, city, who?
Editor,
so you can do it manually and fill all these fields. After that, you save. And it will be there for you. So when you use a book in the library, don't write it on a paper. It will get missing. Use Mendeley to record them. Are you here?
Yes.
Okay. Then let's talk about the final one. Now we've talked about, I should go over this one again. Okay. This instance is used when you don't have the electronic version of the article. So you go to the library, you pick a textbook, very interesting, you know, to your work. You've used it. The traditional thing to do is to write them in a notebook. You get home and then your genius sibling will pick the book and put it in the water. You lose the data, isn't it? Good. But Mendeley gives us that option. So you go to file, then add entry manually. So you click on this and then a window will open for you. Now, depending on the material you use, if I used a book, I have to tell Mendeley that I used a book, because there's a different citation for a book. The citation for a journal is different from a book. Do you understand it? If I used book section, I have to choose book section. If I use conference proceedings, I have to. If I use article, encyclopedia article, I have to show it. Do you understand it? If I use the journal article, I have to show you, so journal article. Then I come here and then fill the various fields, the required fields. Are you here? Good. After filling it, then I save. Then Mendeley will pick it.
Okay.
Now let's talk about the last option. We go back to PubMed. PubMed. Okay. Now you have your articles here. Okay. There's something we need to download. We've not done that, so let's download that one. Let's go back to Mendeley. Go to tools. Can you see tools?
Yeah.
There are two things we will download. One is install web importer. Can you see web importer?
Yes.
Okay, click on web importer. If your tools, those things are not the right, click on it and select it. Okay. So install web importer, and then it will lead you to the Mendeley page. Okay, so while this is loading, let's go back to Mendeley again. Go back to tools. Please, are you following? Go back to tools and then install MS Word plugin. But before you install this one, if you've opened any Word document, please close it.
Word.
If you've opened any Word document, please close it.
Okay.
And then install MS Word plugin. Okay, so mine is successful. I hope yours too is successful.
Information was successful. Okay. Shall we get quiet machine?
Oh,
machine. The guy is supposed to be. Oh, they have to come and get her.
Oh, it's okay, I'll come with her. She's watching the video.
Okay, I'm watching.
Okay, so now when you click on install web importer, it will lead you to this page. Okay,
now
when you come to this page, can you see this icon, save to Mendeley? Can you see it? Click on it and drag to your bookmark menu and leave it there. Can you see save to Mendeley here again now?
Yes.
Now we've moved it to this place.
Wow.
It will be here forever and ever.
Amen.
Good. So you install it on your primary browser, the browser that you use often.
Yes.
Okay. Okay. Now let's go back to our PubMed. PubMed. .org. Okay, now let's do our search again. Malaria in in Ghana. I hope our physical audience are following and our virtual audience too are following. Good. So we want to go to PubMed, and then when it comes, we'll try and search for some articles and see how we can import them into Mendeley.
All right,
but I hope your MS Word importer plugin was installed.
Yes.
Okay, we will use that one very soon.
Oh,
our network. Good. So, again, malaria in Ghana. We are coming to do another magic here, so let's observe. Okay, so this is pre Pastor Chris. Okay, so now we have 981 articles. So this page is displaying 20 of that 981 articles, isn't it? Now we want to import this article, the citation of this article, into Mendeley. Okay, then number 3, non-falciparum malaria infections in pregnant women. Can you say it?
Yeah.
We want to import this one into Mendeley. The only thing we will need to do is just go to save to Mendeley. Can you say it?
Mm-hmm.
Save to Mendeley. I've not selected anything.
Yes,
I just go to save to Mendeley. And let's see what will happen.
The magic of
Oh, but how would you know that you want just a particular one?
You're supposed to know that it's
like. So, Mendeley will tell us what to do.
Yeah.
Are you all following? Are you getting it? Good. Mendeley is creating some magic today. Our internet, our virtual audience will bear with us.
We are in Ghana.
UHAS, School of Medicine.
Togo cell can.
In that case, so whilst we are waiting for Saved Mendeley to download, let's go back to Mendeley. Okay, now we want to start writing. We've learned how to do our write-up, isn't it? Mm-hmm. So in Mendeley, let's pick one PDF. I can double-click on this PDF, and then I can be reading from here. So I can be reading from here, okay? Now, if I read from here, and then I see an interesting thing that I want to cite in my article, I can just copy. So we are. Adam, you have a question?
Yeah.
Yes.
Your bookmark tool by Snowshare.
Right click on the. The.
On the.
Is it two bar?
Yeah.
Yes. It should come.
Menu bar.
Which browser are you using?
Okay, so I'm copying something. Can we see?
Yes,
so. I want to code this thing in my thesis. So I copy it and then I open a Word document. Word. How do I get Word? Okay, so let's use this. And then open a new document. So, we are going to use a new Word document for our practice.
No.
It happens because we have two conflicting this thing on it. This is EndNote. Okay, now I can come and paste it here. Okay, now after pasting, this is not my ideas, it is somebody's ideas. I have to cite it, isn't it?
Yes.
Good. So I want to put my citation here. Now if you want to use the citation in Microsoft Word, always use the references tab. Can you see references?
Yes.
Click on references. Good. Those of us who have not installed the MS Word plugin, you will not have this Mendeley Site-O-Matic group. You will not have it. But if you install the MS Word plugin, you will have it. Can you see it? Good. Now, if I want to insert, I want to cite somebody, I'll go to insert citation. Then I'll go to Mendeley. Do you remember the article we were reading? This one? This one, good. So I just click on it. When I click on it, you see cite. Just cite. Now it cited it for us. Do you get it? Good. Now, depending on the citation style you want, you can always update it. So if I want, say, nature, I can click on nature and then immediately changes. Can you see the change?
Yes.
Can you see the change? Yes. Good. Now, I'm still doing my write-up. So I go back to Mendeley, the same paper I was reading. Oh, no, this time around, let's read another paper, okay? Let's read another paper. This guy's paper is interesting. Let's read it. Good. Very interesting, especially this part. Especially this part. Okay, so we need it. Oh, you didn't read, you see? Okay, so we want to go and paste that one too.
Yes,
good. And then at the end, we want to do our citation. Right. So you go to insert citation, then go to Mendeley, and then this is the article, isn't it?
Yes.
Then you go to cite. This, we are using the nature. Do you get it?
Yes.
At the end of the day, you want to write your bibliography or your reference list. Now you go to insert bibliography. Can you see insert bibliography?
Yeah,
just click on it. And then it creates it for you. Again, assuming this particular article is being prepared for a particular journal, and they are requiring that we use Nature. And then we are preparing another one for another journal that requires, say, Harvard. We can, the same citation, we can go and then update it and choose Harvard. When you choose Harvard, it will reflect the changes. Can you see the changes?
Yeah,
both in text and then the reference list.
Mm-hmm. You don't highlight it.
Can you see it?
Yeah.
So, a very useful tool as researchers. It's very handy. We have to make use of them. We don't have any excuse to tell anybody that I can't see my references. Okay, now I think we let's go and check if our web importer has worked now. Okay, so saved Mendeley. Where is it? Where is our saved Mendeley? Oh, okay, this is what we were using. So the saved Mendeley is still giving us problem. Okay, then I will leave the saved Mendeley. But what it does is, it will open and all these articles will come. Okay? And then it will ask us to select the ones we want to import into Mendeley. Do you understand it? And then we will select, and then it will ask us to open in Mendeley desktop. And then we do it. Now, anytime you finish doing something in Mendeley, try to synchronize. Can you see sync?
Yeah.
Good, synchronize. If I don't synchronize what I'm doing here, and I go and open it on my computer in the office, I'll not see it. Do you understand it?
Mm-hmm.
So always try and synchronize. Do you have any question? Have you exhausted Mendeley?
Yeah. Not at all.
There's share. There's what? Share. Good, so we'll talk about share. Alright, so before I talk about share, when we started, I told that I'll talk about groups, creating groups before I go.
Yes.
Good. Creating groups is also another important feature of Mendeley. This is how it works. A student and a supervisor. If your supervisor wants to share some information with you, you can introduce your supervisor to Mendeley. Let him create an account. And now, when he creates an account, you will create a group and then you invite him. When he accepts your invite, anything you put in the group, any article you put in the group, he can access it. Any bibliographic data you put in the group, he can access it. And vice versa.
But not your personal data.
No. This is research. Okay. So you can go to create groups. There are three groups, three forms of groups. We have the private, not WhatsApp group. We have the private. The private takes only two people. Two members. That's why you and your supervisor can use it. Private. Can you say it?
Are you and your girlfriend okay?
You and your girlfriend. Your serious girlfriend doing the same research, okay?
Why you?
Okay, so now let's read the attributes of the various groups. Private. Share references and full text files. So if I download my, you know, sometimes your supervisors are supposed to help you with some reading list, isn't it?
Mm-hmm.
So they can download some articles for you and put them in the private group, and you can also see them, download them, and then get the bibliographic reference. Yes, I'm not your supervisor. Yes, okay, say it. Yes.
And I'm done with you, and I've got another supervisor. Can I delete you from?
Yes. Yes. And there's another one, invite only. So this one, the lecturers, beginning of your lecture, you are supposed to provide reading list for your students. Okay, so instead of printing them, you can create a Mendeley and then invite your students to Mendeley group. Then you put your reference list there and every student can read them. Do you understand it? Good. So this one, share references only. Public can follow, your students can follow. The public can follow the group only. Good for sharing references or reading list. You understand it?
Mm.
Then we have the open. Share references only. Yes. So you share, you put that in, the people can just read. Okay. So that is that about the groups. Is there anything I've not talked about? I think I've exhausted Mendeley. Yes. The most important thing about Mendeley is practice. If you don't practice, you will forget. It's like EndNote. So we have access to all these tools. Let's begin to write. Okay. Now you have a library on your desktop. All your PDF can be on your desktop. You can read, you can annotate, you can make your notes, and then you can cite. And you can keep your references. On that note, we'll call it a day. And then I hope that this will be a useful exercise for you. Angigo, still surviving. God bless you.